Hello friends, welcome to this YouTube channel. Today we are going to solve a couple of numerical problems on DC shunt motors. By solving these problems, we shall learn how to determine efficiency of a DC shunt motor. We shall also learn how to determine input power and various losses of a DC shunt motor when the values of efficiency and output power are known. Let us first go through the equations we shall use today to solve the numerical problems. In a DC shunt motor, armature and field windings are connected in parallel across a DC source. The current flowing through the shunt field winding ISH equals to V by RSH, where V is the supply voltage and RSH is the resistance of the shunt field winding. Applying Kirchhoff's current law at node A, we get expression for armature current IA equals to IL minus ISH, where IL is the line current taken from the DC source. Supply voltage V equals to EB plus IA times RA plus twice VB, where RA is the armature resistance and VB is the brush contact voltage drop. From this expression, we get back EMF EB equals to V minus IA times RA minus twice VB. Again, expression for back EMF EB equals to 5ZNP divided by 60A, where phi is the useful flux per pole, Z is the number of armature conductors, N is the speed of the motor in revolution per minute, P is the number of poles of the machine, and A is the number of parallel paths of armature winding. Since Z, P and A are fixed for a particular machine, we get EB equals to K phi N, where K equals to ZP divided by 60A is a constant. Input power Pin equals to V into IL. Mechanical power developed in the armature winding PD equals to EB into IA. Output power or shaft power PO equals to PD minus PFR, where PFR is the iron and friction losses of the motor, or PO equals to Pin minus PT, where PT is the total losses. PT equals to PC plus I square times RA, where PC is the constant losses. PC equals to PFR plus ISH square times RSH. Efficiency of the motor, eta equals to PO by Pin. A 10 bhp 230 volt DC shunt motor takes a full load current of 40 ampere. The armature resistance is 0.25 ohm and shunt field resistance is 230 ohm. The total brush drop is 2 volt and the core and friction losses are 380 watt. We have to assume that stray load loss is 1% of the output and calculate efficiency of the motor. Let us first jot down the given data. Supply voltage V equals to 230 volts. Line current IL equals to 40 ampere. Armature resistance RA equals to 0.25 ohm. Shunt field resistance RSH equals to 230 ohm. Given output power PO equals to 10 bhp. Since 1 bhp equals to 746 watts, PO equals to 10 into 746, that is equal to 7460 watts. Total brush contact voltage drop VB equals to 2 volts. Core and friction losses PFR equals to 380 watts. Stray load loss PSTR equals to 1% of PO, that is equal to 0.01 into 7460, that is equal to 74.6 watts. Let us now determine shunt field current. ISH equals to V by RSH, that is equal to 230 divided by 230, that gives us 1 ampere. By subtracting shunt field current from line current, we get armature current. IA equals to IL minus ISH, that is equal to 40 minus 1, that gives us 39 ampere. Let us now determine input power. Pin equals to V into IL, that is equal to 230 into 40, that gives us 9200 watts. Brush contact loss PB equals to VB into IA. Using values, we get 2 into 39, that gives us 78 watts. Let us now determine shunt field copper loss. P copper shunt equals to ISH square times RSH, that is equal to 1 square into 230, that gives us 230 watts. Armature copper loss, P copper armature equals to I square times RA. Using values, we get 39 square into 0.25, that is equal to 380.25 watts. Let us now determine total losses. PT equals to PB plus PFR plus PSTR plus P copper field plus P copper armature. Using values, we get 78 plus 380 plus 74.6 plus 230 plus 380.25. That gives us 1142.85 watts. By subtracting total losses from input power, we get output power. PO equals to Pin minus PT, that is equal to 9200 minus 1142.85, that gives us 8057.15 watts. Let us now determine efficiency of the motor. Eta equals to PO by Pin, that is equal to 8057.15 divided by 9200, that gives us 0.8758 per unit or 87.58%. When running on no load, a 400 volt DC shunt motor takes 5 ampere. The armature resistance is 0.5 ohm and shunt field resistance is 200 ohm. We have to determine the output of the motor and efficiency when running on full load and taking a current of 60 ampere. Let us first jot down the given data. Supply voltage V equals to 400 volts. Armature resistance RA equals to 0.5 ohm. Shunt field resistance RSH equals to 200 ohm. Let us first determine shunt field current. ISH equals to V by RSH, that is equal to 400 divided by 200, that gives us 2 ampere. When the motor runs on no load, line current IL0 equals to 5 ampere. By subtracting shunt field current From line current, we get armature current. Ia0 equals to IL0 minus ISH. That is equal to 5 minus 2. That gives us 3 ampere. Let us now determine no load input power. Pin0 equals to V into IL0. Using values, we get 400 into 5. That gives us 2000 watts. By subtracting armature copper loss from no load input power, we get constant losses. Pc equals to Pin0 minus Ia0 square times Ra. Using values, we get 2000 minus 3 square into 0.5. That gives us 1995.5 watts. When the motor runs on full load, line current IL equals to 60 ampere. Armature current Ia equals to IL minus ISH. Using values, we get 60 minus 2, that is equal to 58 ampere. Let us now calculate input power. V in equals to V into IL, that is equal to 400 into 60, that gives us 24,000 watts. Total losses, Pt equals to Pc plus I square times Ra. That is equal to 1995.5 plus 58 square into 0.5. That gives us 3677.5 watts. Let us now determine output power. PO equals to Pin minus Pt. That is equal to 24,000 minus 3,677.5. That gives us 20,322.5 watts. Efficiency of the motor, eta equals to PO by Pin. That is equal to 20,322.5 divided by 24,000. That gives us 0.846771 per unit or 84.6771%. A 100 volt DC shunt motor develops 6 bhp and the overall efficiency at this load is 86%. The armature resistance is 0.06 ohm and shunt field resistance is 50 ohm. We have to determine the current taken, copper losses and iron and friction losses. Let us first write down the given data. Supply voltage V equals to 100 volts. Output power PO equals to 6 bhp. Since 1 bhp equals to 746 watts, PO equals to 6 into 746, that is equal to 4,476 watts. Overall efficiency, eta equals to 86%, that is equal to 0.86. Given armature resistance, Ra equals to 0.06 ohm. Shunt field resistance, RSH equals to 50 ohm. Let us first calculate input power. Pin equals to PO divided by eta. Using values, we get 4,476 divided by 0.86. That is equal to 5,204.65 watts. Line current IL equals to Pin by V. Using values, we get 5,204.65 divided by 100. That gives us 52.0465 ampere. Let us now determine shunt field current, ISH equals to V by RSH, that is equal to 100 divided by 50, that gives us 2 ampere. By subtracting shunt field current from line current, we get armature current, IA equals to IL minus ISH. Using values, we get 52.0465 minus 2, that is equal to 50.0465 ampere. Neglecting brush contact voltage drops, we get expression for back EMF, EB equals to V minus I times RA. Using values, we get 100 minus 50.0465 into 0.06, that is equal to 96.9972 volts. Developed power, PD equals to EB into IA, that is equal to 96.9972 into 50.0465, that gives us 4854.4 watts. Iron and friction losses, PFR equals to PD minus PO, that is equal to 4854.4 minus 4476, that gives us 378.4 watts. Let us now determine copper losses. P copper equals to P copper shunt plus P copper armature, that is equal to ISH square times RSH plus I square times RA. Using values, we get 2 square into 50 plus 50.0465 square into 0.06, that is equal to 200 plus 150.803, that gives us 350.803 watts. When running on no load, a DC shunt motor takes 6 ampere at 200 volts. The armature resistance is 0.5 ohm and shunt field resistance is 100 ohm. We have to determine efficiency of the motor when output is 5 kilowatt. Let us first jot down the given data. Supply voltage V equals to 200 volts. Armature resistance RA equals to 0.5 ohm. Shunt field resistance RSH equals to 100 ohm. Let us first determine shunt field current, ISH equals to V by RSH. Using values, we get 200 divided by 100, that is equal to 2 ampere. When the motor operates at no load, line current IL0 equals to 6 ampere. Armature current IA0 equals to IL0 minus ISH, that is equal to 6 minus 2, that gives us 4 ampere. Let us now determine input power. Pin0 equals to V into IL0. Using values, we get 200 into 6, that gives us 1200 watts. Constant losses, PC equals to Pin0 minus IA0 squared times RA, that is equal to 1200 minus 4 square into 0.5, that gives us 1192 watts. Iron and friction losses, PFR equals to PC minus ISH square times RSH. Using values, we get 1192 minus 2 square into 100, that gives us 792 watts. When the motor is on load, output power PO equals to 5 kilowatts, that is equal to 5000 watts. Developed power PD equals to PO plus PFR. Using values, we get 5000 plus 792, that is equal to 5792 watts. Again, developed power PD equals to EB into IA. Neglecting brush contact voltage drops, we get expression for back EMF EB equals to V minus IA times RA. Using this expression, we get PD equals to V minus IA times RA into IA. Putting values and simplifying, we get IA square minus 400 times IA plus 11,584 equals to 0. Solving this equation, we get armature current IA equals to 31.4295 ampere. Line current IL equals to ISH plus IA, that is equal to 2 plus 31.4295, that gives us 33.4295 ampere. Let us now determine input power. P in equals to V into IL, that is equal to 200 into 33.4295, that gives us 6685.9 watts. Alternatively, input power P in equals to PO plus PC plus I squared times RA. Using values, we get 5000 plus 1192 plus 31.4295 square into 0.5. That gives us 6685.9 watts. Let us now determine efficiency of the motor. Eta equals to PO by Pin, that is equal to 5000 divided by 6685.9, that gives us 0.7478 per unit or 74.78%. A DC shunt motor takes 5 ampere at no load from 220 volt DC source while running at 800 rpm. The armature resistance is 0.4 ohm and shunt field resistance is 160 ohm. We have to determine the efficiency and the speed of the motor when it takes 45 ampere at 220 volts. The armature reaction weakens the field by 3%. Let us first jot down the given data. Supply voltage V equals to 220 volts. Armature resistance RA equals to 0.4 ohm. Shunt field resistance RSH equals to 160 ohm. Let us first determine shunt field current. ISH equals to V by RSH. Using values, we get 220 divided by 160, that is equal to 1.375 ampere. When the motor runs at no load, line current IL0 equals to 5 ampere. Let the corresponding flux be phi 0. Speed of the motor N0 equals to 800 rpm. Let us now determine armature current. IA0 equals to IL0 minus ISH. Using values, we get 5 minus 1.375, that is equal to 3.625 ampere. Let us now calculate input power. P in 0 equals to V into IL 0. That is equal to 220 into 5. That gives us 1100 watts. Constant losses PC equals to P in 0 minus IA 0 squared times RA. That is equal to 1100 minus 3.625 square into 0.4. That gives us 1094.7438 watts. Neglecting brush contact voltage drop, we get expression for back EMF EB0 equals to V minus IA0 times RA. Using values, we get 220 minus 3.625 into 0.4. That gives us 218.55 volts. When the motor is loaded, line current IL equals to 45 ampere. Let the corresponding flux be phi. According to the problem statement, armature reaction weakens the field by 3%. Therefore, phi equals to 1 minus 0.03 times phi 0, that is equal to 0.97 times phi 0. Armature current IA equals to IL minus ISH, that is equal to 45 minus 1.375, that gives us 43.625 ampere. Input power Pin equals to V into IL, that is equal to 220 into 45, that gives us 9900 watts. Let us now determine total losses. PT equals to PC plus I square times RA. Using values, we get 1094.7438 plus 43.625 square into 0.4. That gives us 1856 watts. Output power PO equals to Pin minus PT, that is equal to 9900 minus 1856, that gives us 8044 watts. Neglecting brush contact voltage drops, we get expression for back EMF EB equals to V minus IA times RA. That is equal to 220 minus 43.625 into 0.4. That gives us 202.55 volts. Let us now determine efficiency of the motor. Eta equals to PO by Pin. Using values, we get 8044 divided by 9900, that gives us 0.8125 per unit or 81.25%. For DC motors, back EMF EB is proportional to phi into N. Therefore, we can write EB by EB0 equals to phi by phi0 into N by N0. From this expression, we get speed N equals to EB by EB0 into phi0 by phi into N0. Using values, we get 202.55 divided by 218.55 into 1 upon 0.97 into 800. That gives us 764.3631 RPM. So today we have solved a couple of numerical problems on DC shunt motors. By solving these problems, we have learned how to determine efficiency of a DC shunt motor. We have also learned how to determine input power and various losses of a deficient motor when values of efficiency and output power are known. Hope this lecture has been useful for you. If you have any suggestions or questions, please drop it in the comment section below. If you have liked this video, give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. Thank you.